Now that we've matched the virtual FarmBot to the FarmBot in real life, we want to make sure that the FarmBot can move to everywhere it needs to be able to go in the garden space so that it can take care of all the plants. To do this, we're going to send the FarmBot to the maximum locations along each axis to make sure there's no problems. If we do run into some problems, we may need to make some hardware adjustments or software setting adjustments. So let's get started. First, we'll start with the x-axis. So I'm going to tell the FarmBot to move all the way to the end of the bed. Now what I'm looking for here is if the FarmBot stalls or gets stuck or anything weird happens that's going to prevent the FarmBot from moving all the way to the end. Now you want to test this in both the positive and negative directions because sometimes things can work one way but not the other. So let's send it back to the home position and make sure that the FarmBot is able to travel all the way back. Some things that you're looking for while running these tests, you want to make sure that the FarmBot is running over a smooth surface. So if there's any bumps on the wood raised bed or along tracks, if you're doing a Genesis system, you want to make sure that you sand those bumps down so that the FarmBot can travel smoothly across. You also want to make sure that the cable carrier is flexing appropriately and not going to run into anything, particularly the end stop here. Sometimes during the initial setup, you maybe knock the FarmBot around a little bit on accident, and by the time you're ready to get going and controlling the FarmBot, the belts have become too loose, or even they've tightened and it will cause extra strain on the motor. So you want to make sure that the belts are properly tensioned at this point. On the software side, you can also adjust motor settings, which will control how quickly the FarmBot moves, how fast it accelerates. So go into the settings panel and first let's open up the motors section. You'll see that you have controls for the max speed along the X, Y, and Z axis. And you also have separate controls for the Z axis when it's moving away from the home position. In this case, that would be down, and also towards the home position, which would be going up. And we provide those extra controls because when the Z axis is moving down, gravity is helping it move down. It's helping the motor. And when it's going up, it's fighting gravity. And so you can adjust the up and down motion for that axis separately to give you a little bit more control and better performance. Now we have a bunch of information on our documentation hub, software.farm.bot, that will help you figure out optimal settings for each of the axes, which are going to be different for Express bots and Genesis bots. And things that you're going to want to be adjusting potentially are max speed, minimum speed, and the accelerate four settings. By default, your account is loaded with default settings that should work with your FarmBot. So when you go into the settings to make changes, you should be making small tweaks. You shouldn't be, you know, taking a value of 100 and making it 1,000. Maybe go from 100 to 120 or from 100 to 80. You should be making small adjustments that help you tune your system. One final setting that you can adjust on the software side is the motor current. Again, by default, we start off your account with settings that are going to be good for most setups, but you can adjust this to be more or less depending on if you're powering your FarmBot with a solar system and you want to conserve energy, or you need a little bit extra oomph to get the FarmBot from point A to point B consistently. So we've got our FarmBot moving pretty nicely along the x-axis. Now let's try it with the y-axis. So go to the controls panel and tell the FarmBot to move all the way across. You're gonna again wanna be looking for any obstructions. There could be bird droppings along the extrusion here. There could be some other buildup. You wanna make sure that it's just not getting stuck anywhere. It can consistently, smoothly move to the end and back again. There we go.